On behalf of Bendigo Senior Secondary College, I would like to officially welcome you all to this very special occasion, our 2022 graduation ceremony. Please thank Uncle Paul Chapman for opening our ceremony. My name is Sam Graham, and along with Inez Harrington, we'll be your hosts for this evening. I would now like to welcome Rafaela Musk and Amelia Leach to say the acknowledgement of country.
Good evening. My name is Raf and this is Amelia. Before we begin tonight's ceremony, we would like to acknowledge and honour that we are meeting on Jarra country. We extend our appreciation to the Jarra Jabberung people, the traditional owners of the land on which we stand. We acknowledge that sovereignty has never been ceded and this always was and always will be Aboriginal land. We pay our respects to leaders and elders, past, present and emerging. They hold the memories, traditions, culture and hopes of all Jarra Jabberung people. We would also like to extend this acknowledgement to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people here with us tonight.
In the last few months, our mob has experienced significant loss in the passings of both Uncle Archie Roach and Uncle Jack Charles. And tonight we would like to honour them both as they pass on, and we thank them for the work they have done for all Indigenous people and how they have fought for us to have a more equal future by paving the way for us all, which is seen through the continuing efforts to achieve self-determination, reconciliation, and the current efforts for treaty and an Indigenous voice to Parliament. As we, the graduating class of 2022, leave today and emerge as future elders and leaders of the country, Honour and respect the country you are on, and also honour your own people and ancestors as you go forwards from today. To the graduating class of 2022, congratulations.
Thank you, Raph and Amelia. My name is Innes Harrington, and it's my pleasure to be one of your hosts this evening. I'd like to now invite our language students to welcome us in their languages of study.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Edward Nicholas. I studied Chinese in year 11. Huanying Guanling Bendige Gaozhong Er Ling Er Er Biye Dianli.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Xiao Chu. I'm learning English as additional language. We welcome you all to our 2022 second graduation ceremony. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Gemma, and I study French. Nous vous souhaitons à tous la bienvenue à notre cérémonie de remise de diplôme 2022.
Good evening. My name is Austin Robbins, and I study German. Zu unserer Abschlussfeier heißen wir euch alle willkommen.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jeremy, and I study Indonesian. Kepada yang hadir, kami ucapkan selamat datang di upacara wisuda untuk tahun 2022.
We would now like to welcome our special guest present this evening, our principal, Dale Pearce, College Council President Damien Tangi and College Council Representatives, Special College Guest Neil Taylor, Victorian Commissioner for LGBTIQ Plus Communities Todd Fernando, Regional Director Angela Singh, Principal of Crusoe College Simon Wood, Principal of Bendigo South East Secondary College Glenn Donald, parents and family members, Bendigo Senior Secondary College staff, and very importantly, our Year 12 graduating students for 2022. To commence our evening, for those who would like to, we now invite you to stand for the Australian National Anthem, performed by Sonny Hannaford, accompanied by Yangfing Ross on piano.
Thank you, Sunny and Yangfeng. Our first guest for this evening is Bendigo senior alumni Ryan Peterson. Ryan is the 2022 Victorian Youth Premier, 2021 and 2022 Deputy Youth Mayor of the City of Greater Bendigo, and was the Youth Mayor in 2020. He is currently studying a Bachelor of Planning at La Trobe University. Ryan has been a voice for the young people of BSSE, Greater Bendigo and the State of Victoria. He has been a member of the 2020 and 2022 Victorian Youth Parliaments, advocating for sustainable building standards and a stronger pathway for medical practitioners in regional Victoria. Ryan is also a founding member of the City of Greater Bendigo Youth Council, which started in 2019. In the past 5 years, Ryan has worked to reduce youth unemployment in Greater Bendigo, increase local government support for the LGBTQIA+ community, improve local education and pathways, raise awareness for regional health services, and ensure that young people are listened to and respected as members of our community. Ryan is a valuable member of our alumni community, and we're thrilled to have him speaking this evening.
Thank you, Ennis. 5 years ago, I was sitting where you are now and wondered which company I'd be working at as a car designer. I thought I might weasel my way into Ferrari or Lamborghini. As you can tell, that didn't happen. Because I was, if anything, too focused on that dream. Had I kept going down that path, I would have never sat in the seat of Premier of Victoria or debated in Parliament House. I doubt I would have ever been able to do something as simple as meet the mayor of Greater Bendigo. I spent so long on a single aspiration that I couldn't see I was leaving behind so many other opportunities. It took me a failed design diploma, a pandemic, multiple jobs, and years of youth leadership to figure out I wanted to apply for a course at a university 5 minutes from my house. I know alumni who were asked to speak at events like this have reputations of being high-flying students and have the time to volunteer in the community and be global citizens. I graduated from VCE with an ATAR of 55. Not even scaling from English language or German could save me. But I scraped through and went in search of the next big thing. That turned out to be town planning. Can't help but feel like I made a wrong turn somewhere, but someone needs to have a say in how our towns and cities grow to meet the needs of a growing population. And like so many other opportunities, I decided I was the best person for the job. Even if I have no real plan of how I'm going to do that. All I know is that I want to help change things and do some good. Since graduating in 2017, I collected a few minor accolades, which you've already heard about. You might wonder what it takes to achieve these sorts of positions. You need just one thing, a desire to push yourself and learn from your opportunities. It's human nature to want to progress and wonder what's next, to plan for the next short-term goal and work towards it. I've never been ready for an opportunity, but I've known that it is something that I want to do. In one way or another, I have this school to thank for that, for being able to sit in on meetings with important people and embarrass them or even myself by being overly direct or talking too much. But that's what I felt I had to do. I had to be brash and get to the point because that's the only way I saw anything getting done. In my experience, that's just being in a very outspoken young person. But it's also the knowledge that your life, all 18 or so years of it, is valuable, is worth sharing, and should be taken notice of. Life experiences, and the more you talk about them that way, the wiser you become. Whenever I go into a meeting, I like to think, what can I give you that you wouldn't get from anyone else? The screenwriter Aaron Sorkin once said, decisions are made by those who show up. If you go through your life knowing that you can give your knowledge, your services, and lived experience, you grow as a person and everything around you will grow as a result. For all of you, the next 5 years will be a balancing act of friends, family, self, and success. So here are a few small notes from me. Take care of yourself more than anything else. Always look for short-term opportunities and do not lose yourself in the long-term pursuit of a dream. Speak up, because sometimes the things that people need to hear are the things that they are the least willing to actually listen to. And don't fake it till you make it. That attitude and that saying is the birthplace of imposter syndrome. Know your worth and never doubt the value of your contributions to anything. all good speeches seem to end with quotes, so I've been told. So here's one of my favourites from anthropologist and writer Margaret Mead. Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, dedicated people can change the world. It's the only thing that ever has. Thank you.
Thank you, Ryan, for your inspiring words. We hope that you've had a chance to look through your graduation booklet, where you'll see the names of all the Year 12 students who are completing their secondary education at BSSE this year. Tonight, we will be acknowledging those students who are able to make it as they come across the stage. Various photos will be taken throughout the evening. We will advise via Compass how to access these. As we have many students being represented tonight, we ask that you hold your applause until the end of each segment. Please now re-welcome our Principal Dale Pierce, who will be making the presentations to our graduates tonight. I'd now like to introduce Student Engagement Coordinator Kate Kelly.
Thank you, Innes. It's my pleasure and privilege to announce the first group of graduating students present here tonight. I would also like to welcome fellow Student Engagement Coordinator Kendall O'Sullivan, who will assist Dale. We congratulate the following students. Logan Anglin. Tash Archer. Maya Armstrong. Talia Arthur. Taylor Atherton. Ben Orcote. Liam Austin. Masama Azimi. Vic Barker. Lily Barker. Samara Bassett. Matt Baxter. Grace Bell. Anna Bijou. Helly Blake Burrows. Klong Kling Bong. Sophie Bokshaw. Gabe Bradshaw. Jack Brady. Jock Brazel. Alicia Bratby. Alana Bretherton. Ava Brindle. Aaron Broad. Jasmine Brotherton. Mackenzie Brower. Braden Brown. Jack Brown. Jessica Brown. Montana Brown. Riley Brown. Riley Bruce. Mohamed Boudet. Deke Bulmer. Matt Burns. Rachel Burnside. Casey Bush. Callahan Butler. Leroy Butler. Kiara Butterworth. Joshua Buttle. Kristen Bai. Harry Bysouth. Dekiah Kale. Laura Kane. Lily Cairns. Thomas Coverley. James Campbell. Sarah Campbell. Taz Caridi. Alexander Carr. Silver Carson. Floyd Kartner. Chloe Kaysen. Ethan Chisholm. Sher Sir Year Christ. Keely Clayton. Oliver Code. Jamie Coles. Riley Comerford. Joshua Condon. Lewis Condon. Isabella Conroy. Al Cook. Jack Cornish. Shayna Croft. Dylan Cunnington. Isabel Kerno. Cody Carroll. Jade Cuskelly. Regan Cuskelly. Tamia Jamchiff. Lily Darmody. Carlo Davis. Jasmine Dorr. Indiana Dellavedova. Orlando Di Maria O'Sullivan. Ian DeMick Formentera. Isabel Dole. Alicia Dominguez. Cameron Downing Mooney. Cody Dreisma. Ollie Duffy. Samantha Duggan. Liam Duven Warden. Gemma Duncan. Takia Eldridge. Alex Epworth. Lockie Feuerhart. Ella Filsell. Ella Finch. Elise Franklin. Ella Flavelle. Elijah Fraser. Harrison Frischke. Liam Gay. Xavier Geary. Geordie Gillis. Curtis Godfrey. Flynn Graham. Georgia Griffin. Connor Griffiths. Emmanuel Haduka. Amber Haig. Forrest Hammond. Xander Hancock. Sunny Hannaford. Tyzak Hassel. Ruby Hink. Jonty Hobbs. Rhianne Hobbs. Geordie Holland. Buese Tu. Moses Tu. Ryan Huddle. Alyssa Hughes. Anthony Hutchinson. Carson James. Imogen Johnson. Haley Jones. Jaden Jow. Montana Justice. Alana Jersey Hall. Gemma Carms Taylor. Gabby Kane. Jude Kay. Muhammad Khan. Jared Kirkpatrick. Daniel Keep. Jeremy Cridmayer. Congratulations to all students who have just been presented. Also a big thank you to Dale and Kendall. It's my pleasure to now introduce Sunny Hannaford and Carlo Davis to sing Say a Little Prayer. They will be accompanied by Hanley Rourke and Ethan Teasdale.
Stay. hurt you, please love me true. This is my prayer. Answer my prayer now. This is my prayer. Answer my prayer now.
Please thank Sonny, Carlo and Hanley and Ethan for their wonderful performance this evening. I now welcome back to the stage Dale Pearce and Assistant Principal Lauren Martin to present our next group of graduating students.
Thank you, Sam. It is my absolute pleasure to announce the next group of graduating students present here tonight. I welcome to the stage Student Engagement Coordinator Hamish Bolton, who will assist Dale. We congratulate the following students. Mumu. Lujo. Ruby Lacey, Elise Ladlaw-Gleary, Darcy Langdon, Keela Larson, Georgia Lee, Jack Lee, Cameron Lead, John Shaw, Austin Long, Kai Lister, Will Long, Zach Lord, Shelby Lowe, Adam Lumsden Hill, Ajak Maboya, Aki Star McCrae, Kaylee McCrae, Benjamin Maggs, Joshua Mandara, Luka Markovic, Alicia Martin, Oliver Martin, Riley Martin, Brooke Maisie, Alex MacArthur, Ryan McClure, Daniel McColl, Gabrielle McCoy, B. McAvoy, Georgia McKellar, Mia McKenna, Joseph McCoy, Liam McClemman, Zach Miller, Chanel Mastika, Hase Kapoor, Lamal Mu, Clermu, Kuala Kri, Lei Mon Pu, Caleb Moon, Ben Moyman, Leximos, Izzy Mountjoy Austin, Salu Mu Mu, Shamu, Byron Mulryan, Tanaka Manakanwai, Taylor Murphy, Porsina, Deacon Nagel, Tapi Natnat, Edward Nicholas, Molly Nicholson, Liam Nixon, Kieran Noble, Mula Wu, Ruby O'Sullivan, Kevin Padamadden, Dakota Page, Sule Kwepe, Lisa Panai, Gemma Pierce, Taylor Patching, Indigo Patterson, Rani Petraio, Chelsea Patterson, December Poor, Uwa Poor, Lulu Sepo, Prepaw Poor, Sepo, Zane Pierce, Jet Pearson, Daisy Purley, Lavinia Peterson, Sado Mupo, Riley Power, Abby Priest, Mupwe, Max Quinn, Bailey Rockstraw, Teacher Rakunov, Jared Ramirez, Astarana Magar, Mia Reed, Faith Reed, Clancy Richardson, Ray Riding, Zach Rivas Monaro, Austin Robbins, Haley Robinson, Montana Roberts, Hanley Rourke, Maya Rossi, Kara Saab, Adeline Sanders, Ryan Savvy, Cole Sawyer, Isabel Schaefer, Sam Skoltons, Say Mayer, Destiny Seymour, Tiani Shackles, Kimberly Sims, Angus Gurkha, Alana Smith, Jenna Smith, Oscar Smith, Kate Snowden, Sardar Sow, Musa Sow, Taylor Spedding, Mitchell Spur, Brandy Stewart, Zali Stewart, Charlie Stump, Bodie Sutcliffe, Sky Swanson, Sam Syme, Campbell Tangy, Lockie Taylor Dowsey, Ethan Teasdale, Thay Mong, Liam Thomas, Maggie Thompson, Leah Thorpe, Emma Trelfel, Talia Till Curtis, Will Truick, Anika Trinidad, Will Troy, Esther Tulmino, Nayla Tone, La Plewa, Ethan Walker, Jacob Walsh, Charlie Watson, yes, come on, get in there. Molly Welton, Chao Shu Wang, Bailey West, Dylan Weston, Emily White, Izzy White, Tyler Wilkie, Ashton Wilson, Emily Wright, Matthew Wright, Kai Younger, Jonah Zock, Jinghong Zhu, Jake Gilhooney, yes, George Mitchin Kimpton, Riley Pato, Mike Kirali, Saxton Dowling, Isaac Graham, Dane Cavallaro. Congratulations to all students who have just been presented, and thank you to Dale and Hamish. I would now like to take this opportunity to thank our Year 12 Student Engagement Team. These staff have worked tirelessly to support the academic progress, engagement and well-being of all students for the past 2 years. Please join me in thanking Hamish Bolton, Kate Kelly and Kendall O'Sullivan. We also thank all advisers for the great support you have provided to our students throughout the year. Ash Bird, Ronnie Bishop, Marion Corbett, Vivian Cox, Wayne Cox, Christina Finch, Amy Greenwood, Lucy Moe, Jenny Maloney.
Please thank Lauren Martin for presenting our final group of graduating students this evening. Thank you also to Ash Bird, Christina Finch, and our music students for the wonderful entertainment tonight. I now invite our college principal, Dale Pearce, to make his graduation presentation.
Thanks, Innes, and thanks, Sam. I'll come back to you and thank you again a little bit later, just before we close, for hosting tonight's proceedings. Just before I do start, I want to thank Uncle Paul Chapman for his role in this evening's proceedings. It's a real pleasure and an honour to have him here with us this evening. I told the first group through that I'm one of Uncle Paul's failed didgeridoo students, but I continue to watch and take lessons, and perhaps I'll pick it up at some stage. So it is a really special occasion. I know parents, you'll be feeling this is 13 years of education coming to an end, and you'll feel a little sadness and no doubt a lot of pride with that too. But I just want to probably start in a more formal sense by saying that tonight we acknowledge the achievement of Year 12 students in reaching the conclusion of that formal secondary education. And I want to acknowledge the presence here tonight of parents and family members, all of you, because it's your support and your direction and your love that has shaped and will continue to shape these young people in the background here, your son or your daughter. You will shape them much more than the capacity of this or any other school. And I know how proud you'll be of your children this evening and how proud you are of them all the time. But it won't be just students to hear tonight who will be both nervous and excited about what lies ahead, because parents will share that as well. Schools and individual teachers too obviously have played a role in preparing these young people and these young men and women for life. And I always feel a great deal of pride and a great deal of privilege to stand here on an occasion like this and to on behalf of all of the schools and all of the teachers who contributed to the lives and education of these young people during their progression from a tiny little smiley face preppy through to what you see here this evening. Of course, this particular group of students has endured all sorts of challenges with COVID, but at least 2022 has been a little more like normal. I know that some of the students here tonight have been hit over the last week or so with some interrupted journeys to school because of localised flooding, and probably the last thing you needed in your journey. But it's been a big investment of time and commitment and everything to get you through here. It's really a significant moment, I think. The success of students from here really depends as much on the type of person they'll become as it will on the results that they take away from school. So for VCE students, of course, the exams lie ahead over the next few weeks and then the nervous wait for results. And while some of those students may get a surprise, for the most part, their results are going to reflect the results they've been achieving throughout the year and students will naturally have different expectations and plans for their future. Our VCAL students too, of course, have worked really hard to try and set themselves up for their pathway, whether that's to TAFE apprenticeship, whether it's to work, and the skills and capabilities that you have developed will provide the basis for your success in the future as well. I always think that the size and nature of our school means that we have great diversity amongst our students. It's one of the great characteristics of this school. I think the other one being the relationships between the adults and the students here. But that diversity is a really important part of the education that we provide our students with, because we give them the opportunity to mix with others who are different in some way, different to them in some way, because that's what's going to happen in your future. That's what your future will hold. So I want you to remember as students when you walk away to be aware of who you are, be proud of who you are, and be proud of where you come from, but also appreciate that difference in others. I think it's really important. And if everybody did that, we'd live in a better world. All of our graduating students will have choices to make very soon. Please make them good ones. You'll have choices to make this evening. You'll have choices to make over the coming weeks and the coming months and years. Please make those good choices, because your local community, our state, our country, we all depend upon you making good choices. That's what shapes our community. That's what shapes our world. And we know that our young people are really passionate and really driven about certain things. So make the right choices, make the right decisions, make a difference. And please don't ever lose that passion or that desire to do good, not just for yourself, but on behalf of others. Because we are a society, we're not just a collection of individual people. And what you do and what you say matters. So no matter where your future takes you, we wish you well, and we hope that you'll live a really rich and a fulfilling life, and you'll look back with some fondness on your time here at our college. So congratulations once more to all of our graduating students, and thanks again to parents and guests for your attendance here tonight. And I'd now invite you to turn your eyes to the screen for a special little presentation for our graduating students.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends, yes I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree, we can rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. We safely walk to school without a sound. Well, here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell, nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball, then back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. The teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass, 'cause we don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. The teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes it when you sing. Tonight I'll dream in my bed while silly thoughts run through my head of the bugs and alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet you and I will walk together again. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I may see you, I may tell you to run.
say about the young?
On the way. On the way.
Well, pick me up with golden hand. I may see you. I may tell you to run.
On the way. On the way.
You know they say about the young?
On the way.
When the stars began to fall right out of the sky.
I'd like to welcome back to the stage our Year 12 Student Leadership Team leaders for 2022, Kieran Noble, Mohammed Khan and Elise Laidlaw-Greeley to respond on behalf of our Year 12 students.
Thank you, Sam. What a ride. To say that we have graduated in 2022 is no mean feat. Riding on the back of a pandemic, we have finished Year 12, one of, if not the most important years of our lives to date. Learning through COVID was tough and is most certainly a low point in my life. For many of us, COVID meant fear, lack of motivation, loneliness, loss of opportunity. Certainly not the ideal way to begin Year 12. The stress of the last few years was sadly not something that immediately dissipated as the new year ticked over, and Year 12 isn't exactly the most relaxing year. As much as we would love to forget these last few years, I would like to ask each and every one of you over the next few weeks to reflect on your time as a student at BSSC, to remember your struggle, and to consider what an immense achievement that making it through Year 12, let alone Year 12 in 2022, is. With this achievement in mind, I hope that we can begin this next phase of our lives with the understanding that when we dig deep and push forward, we can get through challenging times and make the most of our situation. Though many people, myself included, tend to stress about Year 12 achievement, if anything is a marker of success, it is the qualities you have exhibited over these past few years. We observe teamwork, kindness, empathy, courage, and determination, attributes that will hopefully contribute to our continued success. I've had the pleasure of meeting and getting to know what feels like a lot of you, yet walking across this stage today with so many faces I didn't recognise. The small bunch of students who I've come to know are just a sample of the many wonderful people sitting in the audience tonight, every one of whom is a completely unique person, a person who is able to do something in the world in a way that no one else can. Though we are such different people, one thing I've learned during my time at BSSC is that no matter our differences in our paths or the approach we take to our lives, we are stronger together, something that has been proven many times over these past 2 years. So thank you to the class of 2022 for being so tough and pushing through these 2 years alongside me and alongside each other. The potential in this room is undeniable, and I cannot wait to see where you all end up. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Kieran. On behalf of all of the Year 12s, we would now like to focus our appreciation on our parents, carers, and other important people who have supported us throughout not just this final year, but the 12 preceding them as well. Without your guidance, encouragement, and stability, we would not all be here today. Truly, our graduation is as big of an achievement for you as it is for us. Whether it was picking and dropping us up from school, asking about how our assessments went, listening to us stress over homework and exams, or simply providing a place for us to recharge and do it all again tomorrow, we sincerely thank you for the effort that you have made for us and our educations. To say that our years of high school were improved because of you guys is an understatement. Our parents, guardians, and whole support systems have been the force that pushed us towards studying for the next SAC or preparing for the next assessment, even when we were tired of it. You motivated us to succeed. I am sure we have all heard of the African proverb, "It takes a village to raise a child." And on behalf of the Year 12 cohort, I'd like to thank our villagers for everything that you have done for us. We hope you all know how much we appreciate the time and sacrifice you have put into our lives and our education. We could not have done this without you.
Thank you, Elise. Graduates, family members and staff, it is an honour for me to be here tonight to extend my gratitude and greetings to all the teachers and staff here at BSSC. As we scrutinise the significance of this very momentous event, an event I believe is very important and plays a significant role in the symbolism of change and progression and of us moving into our own adventures. It tells us that today is not just a day where we are celebrating the achievements, but perhaps more importantly, a day of benevolence, a time to express our gratitude to the people behind the success, a tribute to the teachers and staff here at BSSC. I'd like to thank all our staff who put forth immeasurable effort to create a tidy and organized atmosphere where we could perform to our fullest potential. Thank you to the career advisors who assisted us in moving forward into our next stages of life. To the wellbeing team for supporting us through this emotional journey, and to all the other staff members. Last but not least, I'd like to thank the teachers for their assiduous care for us. We depart from the school not with just the knowledge and skill that our teachers have given us, but life lessons, but valuable life lessons, ethics and inspirations as we step into the world that lies ahead. We sincerely appreciate everything that you have done to prepare us all for our exams thus far, as well as supporting us through moments of uncertainty. We are forever indebted to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kieran, Muhammad, and Elise. Ines and I would also like to congratulate all students on your achievements this year and wish you well for your exams. We thank you all for your involvement in our ceremony tonight and welcome back Dale Pearce to conclude our ceremony.
Thanks, Sam and Ines again. I just want to perhaps start this section of proceedings by asking just one final time for parents and family members, not students, but parents and family members, those of you up the top, those of you all down here, the 700 or so of you who are here to watch our students, to put your hands together one last time for our graduating class of 2022. I want to thank our hosts Sam and Ines again. Thank you to the team of staff who have helped to plan this ceremony, Lauren, Joe and Danielle and all the support staff who work with them. Special thanks again to Uncle Paul Chapman for the ongoing support he provides to our college. And I'd also like to thank our communications team, John, Paul and Jenny, for the photos they've taken this evening and remind you that those will be available via a link that we'll provide to you through Compass, and those are always really popular. For those who would like to have a student photo in an academic gown, just a reminder that that's available to you across in the Stratagem Studio when we finish. And we're really looking forward to our last day with our Year 12 and the celebrations tomorrow that'll run from 9 until 11:30, and when we will really cheerfully return duty of care back to you as parents and carers. I want to encourage all students to please make sure that you celebrate the end of classes safely, and for our VCE students in particular to make sure they maintain focus on exams over the next month or so. I want to wish you all, every one of our students, success in achieving a positive and sustainable pathway for 2023, whether that's to university, TAFE, work or some other form of training, wherever you're going. I hope that all of you can enjoy some quality family time together tonight where you can reflect on the great achievements as a family and getting to the end of your secondary schooling. It's a really significant occasion. I'd like you to stay just for a few minutes. That's the end of the talking, but I'd like you to stay and enjoy a final musical item by Sonny Hannaford, Kalo Davis, Alana Jurasic Hall, Jonah Zock, Ethan Teasdale, Hanley Rourke and Nathan Edwards. I've got an Elton John medley, which is just fantastic. Please stay with us until the end of that, and that's the end of our proceedings. Thank you again for coming along this evening. I'm sure you're going to love this performance. Thanks, everyone.
stayed on the farm. I should have listened to my old man. You know you can't hold me forever. I didn't sign up for you. I'm not a present for your friends to open. This boy's too young to be singing.
Together, the spotlight's hitting something that